He's been waiting since May for the double transplant that could save his life. He's got it, and now David Kresch says he feels better than he has in a long time. Only 12 heart-liver transplants have been done in the country this year. Last month, a team of doctors at the University of Maryland Medical Center performed their third.
Yeah. Now, Kresch's doctors in Georgia believe he would not survive without the double transplant and contacted the university. 11 News reporter Lisa Robinson is live in the newsroom with more on the story. Lisa?
David Kresch's mother says her son looks a lot different these days. She says she didn't realize her son had such a beautiful complexion. She says because of his heart problems, his skin color was always kind of gray. But now when he smiles, she sees pink cheeks.
I feel a lot better than I did all my life. You know, all my life I've never had this health that I have now. And I can tell the difference, and it's great.
10 hours after receiving a heart-liver transplant at the University of Maryland Medical Center, David Kresch gave his family a thumbs up. He was born with a rare form of congenital heart disease called pulmonary atresia.
They said I wouldn't live up to my 10th birthday, and now I just turned 28 a month ago.
Since he was born, David's gone through 7 surgeries, but it was the last one that doctors hope is a cure. Last May, he was medevaced here from Georgia for the double transplant. Dr. Erica Feller says he needed the liver because the heart disease left it severely scarred. She showed us his left and right ventricles before surgery.
They're not contracting well, and they're very big, and you can see the slow flow of blood flow through both of those ventricles. David's been waiting for his heart and liver transplant since May, and we didn't really know how long it was going to take because we're used to sort of knowing about just the hearts or just the livers and being able to sort of decide on that, and we just got very lucky. This is David Kresch's ultrasound of his heart after the transplant, and you can see the right ventricle and the left ventricle, which are normal. Let me take a listen to you.
It's been a month since his surgery, and doctors say David is doing well. He says his family and his faith got him where he is today.
Keep God in your spirits and pray, and he'll do the right thing for you and your family, because there's always miracles that happen every day.
Now, David says he has to stay in Baltimore for 6 months so doctors can monitor his progress. But he says when he returns to Georgia, he hopes to finish college to become an elementary school teacher. Live in the newsroom, Lisa Robinson, WBAL-TV 11 News. Amazing.